everyone. My name is Dalton Young, and I am both the writer and director of my one-act play titled With Love Always, starring my dear friend Elijah Biggers and the voice of Dylan Bradley. With Love Always is a story of loss, denial, and eventual acceptance of losing a loved one. I wrote this piece keeping in mind that my peers were each writing comedic pieces, so I wanted to have something that would really tug on your heartstrings. And Kelly told me to thank my crew, so I'd like to thank Elijah and Dylan for being here and bearing with me. I'd like to thank Kelby for actually putting this on, MCT in general, and I'd like to thank all of you for actually coming out and supporting the arts and seeing this. I would also like to mention before we begin that this play mentions death and illness, so if this is a sensitive topic for you, you have been warned. And now I present to you With Love Always.
June 5th, 1968. Dear Penny, it has been nearly a month since you left. Even though we've been sending letters, I wanted to write this to you so you may read it when you return. You've told me that your mother's doing well, although you also said she isn't well enough to be on her own yet. Your sister paid a visit last week to ask how I'm doing without you. I told her I'm managing. I'm more worried about keeping my garden here alive than myself. Jokes aside, I miss you. I miss Carol, our neighbor. Make sure to bring me leftovers since you're not here to cook for me after work. She has this inner head that I can't feed myself. But I appreciate her chicken and dumplings. As good as yours, though. With love. Wait. March 23rd, 1970. Dear Penny, it's been almost 2 years since you've left. Your sister comes over often to visit with her new husband, Jacob. She says you're doing well, as your letter suggests. But your mother has gotten worse. I wish I could. But at least I'm here taking care of our garden. I know you don't like them. I replaced our marigolds with roses. Miss Carol helped me plant them. Few of them are often doomed. You always said nothing was perfect, right? I guess that's what your mother said when we told her we were going to marry. You cried after that. But I think we can laugh about it when you get back. With love, Penny. December 21st, 1975. Dear Penelope, it has been 7 years since you have left, and you're still writing letters to each other, but yours are getting more sparse. You picked up a job at the factory to support your mother, and I hope that's why you're not writing. Supposed to marry 3 years ago. But you can't leave your mother. Your sister is with you now. She doesn't come to visit anymore. Her husband didn't last long, though, which is why I suppose she left. I was there during their last argument, and it wasn't what I would call stable.
Why do you always do this?
Oh, that's correct.
I never liked him much anyway. I replaced the roses at your request with peonies. I don't like them. Our garden is getting harder to keep track of. But Miss Carol has been helping me. In our upper years. I guess we're getting in our upper years now, aren't we? With love, Rick. January 8th, 1980. Dear Penelope, Miss Carol died a few days ago. I would have told you in a letter, but I'm not sure you even got the last one. I overheard her family next door after we visited her for the final time. Being taken over by a powdery mildew. I've managed to salvage what I can, but some of it is dead already. It would have been our eighth wedding anniversary. Here for you, God. My brother. He had his first child last year, so now we have a ring bearer for when you come back. I've been telling him stories about us even though he won't remember. Do you still want kids? I really hope to see you soon, Penny. I miss you. Where's love, Quinn? September 21st, 1987. Dear Penelope, you have not written in 6 months. You said that you're busy, but I am offended that I cannot be included in your schedule. As much that I have written you, taking care of your garden, your home, can't even have me in your daily life. You once told me that I was the love of your life. I can't believe that anymore. Ben. October 5th, 1993. Dear Penny, I am sorry for what I said in that last one. I had a bad day, and I took it out without any better judgments. If you read this, please forgive me. And if you don't, it's like this never happened. With love, always. Ben. November 30th, 2000. Dear Penelope, you haven't written in 13 years. Are you mad at me? Whatever I did, I am sorry. I miss you. With love, always. But February 19th,
2023. Dear Penelope, I hope that you are well. I don't think you're coming home. But I am writing to you. It is all that I have at this age. The garden is gone. I guess I neglected it out of sadness, anger. It is full of weeds. Nephews come over all the time asking them. I tell them how we fell in love and how I loved you more than anything. They ask where you went, and I told them that you're taking care of your mother. Years ago to tell me the news. Your sister will tell me where you are or what happened. But whatever made you leave, I'm so sorry. I've submitted this journal to the local theater company. Who is performing my writings tonight? And I wish you could come. If even just for a minute. There is so much that I could do just a minute. I love you. Always.
Great.